solemnly swear or affirm your testimony you're about to give in the matter now pending shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God. Have a seat, please, ma'am. As a matter of trying to move this along, what I've done is I will mark this exhibit as plaintiff's 20, it's just the witnesses, background experience and education. And what I'll do, Judge, is as other witnesses come in, we will just add a page to this exhibit so that we can spend, we can move forward. It will still be in the record their qualifications.
Your Honor, any objection?
No, sir. All
right. Tell the judge your name, please, ma'am.
My name is Aleisha Rucker-Wright.
And how are you employed?
I've been employed with the Dawson County Sheriff's Office for over 9 years. I initially began my employment in 2008 as a communications officer. I was then promoted to communications supervisor, and my position was reclassified as a 911 information technology specialist. During that time, I was also tasked with crime analysis. I have since been promoted to 911 director.
All right, and is there any other rank within the Sheriff's Department other than 911 director?
No.
We'll show you, and we're going to mark this as Exhibit 20, that you prepare a summary for me of your background, experience, and education.
Yes.
I know that's difficult to see if that's clear up. We'll show you the actual exhibit. Is this a true and accurate copy showing us your background, experience, and education?
Yes.
I'm going to go ahead and move to admit this part of Plaintiff's Exhibit 20, Your Honor.
Any objection?
No, sir.
It's admitted.
Okay. Now, what are you started into this before I stopped you. What are your duties currently with Dawson County Sheriff's Office?
Currently, I oversee the daily operations of the 911 center. However, I also still assist in various activities such as crime analysis, information technology, and things of that sort.
Okay. And what function does that division of this 911 perform for the Sheriff's Office and other emergency services?
The Dawson County 911 Center processes all incoming and outgoing calls for service from citizens and outside agencies. They also serve as the liaison for the Dawson County Sheriff's Office and Dawson County Emergency Services.
Now, are you aware, do you have documents there with you regarding the calls for service from 2015 to 2017?
Yes, I do.
That information, does it include officer-initiated activity?
Yes.
And tell the court what officer-initiated activity is.
Our CAD system, which is a computer-aided dispatch, allows us to track all incoming and outgoing calls for service. So essentially, calls are typically generated in one of two ways. Either a citizen or an outside agency will call and request assistance from the Dawson County Sheriff's Office, or the activity is initiated by the officer on scene.
And does the information you have also include criminal investigation division case assignment?
My previous role as the IT administrator for the Dawson County Sheriff's Office has allowed me to glean an understanding of the records management system, which is used in case management.
All right, tell me what that is, records management system.
We have a records management system where all information is input, so all incoming calls for service, all incident reports, all case management activities, citations. Essentially, it serves as the primary repository for all information pertaining to activities for the Dawson County Sheriff's Office, with the exception of the detention center.
All right. And from the information that you have or that you have control over, are you able to identify an increase in case types or types of cases that are assigned or that are received?
Yes, we are.
All right. Now, then tell the judge the number of calls for law enforcement services between 2015 to 2017.
During 2017, in regards to all officer initiated as well as calls for service received, in 2015 we received 61,241 calls. In 2016, this number declined to 54,679. However, we noticed an increase in 2017 of 65,963 calls. So overall, there's an increase in calls for service.
And as to officer-initiated activity, is the information available to you provide that information?
Yes, that information has increased as well. In 2015, we notated approximately, or actually 11,060 calls. In 2017, this number increased to 11,494 calls.
Okay, and so when that says officer initiated activity, that were, that's officers calling in to the 911 center?
Yes, via radio.
And as to the case assignment to the Criminal Investigation Division, what does your statistical information indicate as to the increase or decrease in case assignment?
As far as case assignments, either criminal investigation cases can be assigned through reports received from citizens, or cases can also be initiated, such as drug investigations. In 2015, there was a total of 399 cases worked, compared to 484 cases in 2017.
Now, as to case types, does the information indicate an increase in any specific case types?
Yes, there has been an increase in assault investigations, forgery. There's also been an increase in sexual offenses. There's been a marked increase in domestic violence investigations, with 2015 requiring only 20 investigations. However, 2017 required 72 investigations. Narcotic investigations have actually, which is a self-initiated activity, have decreased from 68 investigations to 51 during 2017. There's also been a marked increase in child abuse molestations investigations from 14 in 2015 to 28 in 2017. We're also showing an increase in entering autos, criminal trespass, missing person investigations, as well as shoplifting. Shoplifting has increased from 5 cases in 2015 to over 16 in 2017.
Over how many?
Over 16 in 2017.
Now, in connection with your function there with A911, or your training of other folks in 911, do you have also contact with the Georgia State Patrol?
Yes, we do.
Right. Now, are they, ever call them for assistance?
Yes, the Dawson County Sheriff's Office actually has entered into service agreements with Georgia State Patrol, and during specified hours, they serve as our primary responders for motor vehicle accidents.
Why is that?
Typically, that occurs because they're often able to respond to an incident perhaps faster, or in the event that we have multiple incidents going on, we rely upon them so that our deputies can then be freed up to respond to other incidents that are occurring.
Georgia State Patrol, they're not beholden to the county for those calls, if I understand?
No, as a matter of fact, within the Dawson County 911 Center, we are actually the primary unit responsible for contacting Georgia State Patrol. There have been multiple times when we have contacted Georgia State Patrol, and either they tell us they are responding from Lumpkin or Forsyth County and will have an extended ETA, or they are not available to respond.
So, can you tell the judge overall the number of calls between 2015 to 2017, has that increased, decreased, or plateaued?
As far as motor vehicle accidents that required an incident report, the overall totals have increased. 2015, there were 1,226. This number increased to 1,352. What's interesting about this as well is, of these accidents, in 2015, we relied upon Georgia State Patrol to respond to and work 467 cases. This number has now increased to 654 during 2017. You can also see, looking from Georgia State Patrol stats, that they are primarily our DUI enforcement for Dawson County. Their DUI arrests were approximately 50 in 2015, and that's increased to 76 during 2017. And the number of citations issued from Georgia State Patrol has increased, as the number of citations issued from Dawson County deputies has decreased.
Okay. happen to have another copy of this?
I do.
We've got one, Sheriff.
Oh, okay, very good.
Got some of his notes ready.
Did you get my good side?
I'm not sure what number we were on at this point. I think it was R24 was the last one.
Stick with it.
Okay.
So you had one respondent's exhibit marked, that was the 24, I should.
That's what I'm thinking.
Thank you.
Here you go, Lynn.
This will be R25.
She's got a claim on it. Thank you.
Let me ask you, what has been marked R25 consists of? What can you tell the court it is?
This is actually a summary of activity from 2015 to 2017 for Dawson County Sheriff's Office.
Consisting of four pages?
Yes, consisting of four pages.
Any objection to 25?
No, thank you.
Submit.
A couple of things that you may can help me clarify in the moment. Bill Halsworth was talking earlier in his presentation about the basis that he used for some of his work hour calculations and some of his study findings. He used the term number of dispatched calls, which he indicated were 10,107 for 2014. Does that terminology, this number of dispatched calls, match up with any of those terms that you use? The law enforcement calls for service, officer initiated activity, non-officer initiated activity. Is there one of those that matches up with?
Can you repeat the total again?
Yes. Mr. Halsworth talked in terms of what his study refers to as the number of dispatched calls. And of course, he was looking at 2014. The number he had was 10,107. Does that parallel a term that you've used here in kind of tracking similar information? Is number of dispatched calls the same thing as officer-initiated activity, for example, or one of those other categories?
The number of dispatched calls will correspond with non-officer-initiated calls. Those will be reflective of calls received from citizens or outside agencies.
Give me just a minute, I'm trying to check the trend and see how that goes back in here. Non-officer initiated activity, according to your records, 2015, 11,060?
That is correct, yes.
16 is 10,931?
Yes.
17 is 11,494?
Yes.
And then his number from his study for 14 is 10,107. So it varies from year to year, but it's been between 10 and 12,000 each year during those 4 years. Is that correct?
I don't have the information from the Georgia Sheriff's Association, so I can only document that we have an increase from 15 to 17.
Okay. assuming that the 2014 figure was 10,107?
If that is the assumption the court is making, yes.
Give it just a moment. I may not have anything further, but I want to take a look. I think that's all I have, just had that admitted, so I think that's it. Thank you.
Read it, Rick.
No, thank you. Come down, ma'am.
Are you next?
Thank you. I'll do it. We'll call Matt Hester, Your Honor.